You didn't have a car very much, it seems like.
Really?
All the phones that we needed, like the cars, they were gonna work on somebody to drive the mission boat. And then, as almost the night before, we were getting on the plane to go back. The president called and said, "Oh, you're actually being transferred again back to Tonga. You're not staying there." So I was kind of bummed out. I was like, "Oh, really? I just fought my life and soul."
Good.
Oh, that's good. Did you have any time to do work, like teach people?
In the last 2 weeks?
Yeah.
Because, especially the very last week, they kind of locked everything down, like completely in the field, like India. Like, if anybody went out past 8 o'clock at night, they'd beat them up.
I remember you said you needed to go do some ninja deliveries or something.
Yeah.
So that was it. So during the day, you're allowed to go out for like supplies. But whenever the missionaries would walk on the street, the soldiers who were driving around would say, "Hey, go back home. You're not supposed to be out." You know how like we're going to everybody's house, like the PC.
Sure.
Right.
And so they were like, "No, go back to your house." And so like our missionaries, they were calling us like, "Hey, we need food."
Yeah.
And like people were getting like checkpointed, so we had to figure out where the checkpoints were. So,
it really was ninja errands.
Yeah. But everybody got food. Everything was good.
That's good.
It was like the military for the country. Wow. That's serious.
There's videos of that military. They're pretty, well, the ones at least I got to see, they're pretty tough.
Yeah, they're like, they're all fighters.
Yeah.
And they were just, they're really happy to have like a job. They don't really have like a specific thing to do. So they're like, all right, checkpoints. Like, all right, we're going to
yeah.
do it. We're going to do it big.
They're like, if anybody's out past 8 o'clock, beat them up.
Orders.
Yes, yeah, they said like they were baking, they had their kids help baking. He was not running cookies, the wife was not running cookies, and I think his cousins were running out.
Oh, that's so nice.
So we were the very last ones. So yeah, it was really nice that everybody needed that for everyone.
She wrote us a nice note. Was it her or the husband?
It was her.
It wouldn't cost any money for us to call to each other.
Uh-huh.
And so I apologized to him, like, "Well, send me everybody who you need to get cookies to, and I'll call them all and I'll text them one for them to be ready when you come around."
That's good.
So they wouldn't have to spend all that money.
I always hope that was a good source of income for them. Yeah, they look good.
They look good.
They were really good.
And then she said, she posted today that she baked a whole bunch for when people were leaving.
I didn't get to see them. Because I was doing like passports and helping everybody fill out their forms. Stuff like that. And then I was inside. I didn't want to go outside and look for them. But like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Good. It's a little piece of home, right? Yeah, I don't know who the missionaries are on the second level, videoing down and calling down to you guys when you guys were walking out.
Oh, yeah, that was the
AP. Oh, and they're from Tonga.
Yes. Can you go straight, man?
I was just going to miss them. Do you want to go to Whataburger?
Yeah,
Whataburger is. Okay, but you keep your money in.
Figure all that.
Sister Tato, I said that whatever I don't use out of this money goes back to the board. Five stuff.
Oh.
Okay.
So if we'd like to, you can use it.
What do you think, huh?
Otherwise, it's fine.
Okay. So we really can't take either off. Is that what
you're saying? Yeah, it's
fine. Yeah, Whataburger's here.
Yeah.
I'm a bad dinner tonight.
Wait! Did you get all your money transferred back over to American dollars?
Yes, so one missionary in my zone had a lot of American money in that safe in the office. So when we brought it to him, I was like, hey, I'll trade you $100. You just give it to me. But I tried to go to the bank and like, the lady was just giving me a hard time. It wasn't like she wasn't giving me a hard time, she just couldn't understand. Like, I was like, no, I want American money. She's like, oh yeah, I can do that. Like, the ATMs can just like transmute that automatically. And I was like, no,
I'll
American.
Trade you.
And she's like, yeah, just go outside the ATM. And I was like, okay. But I pulled out 100 worth in going on the ATM.
Tongan dollars?
Mm-hmm. 100 in American worth in some.
Oh.
And then I just traded him. I was like, okay, give me that 100 and I'll give you this.
Oh, smart.
And he was staying over there?
And so he lives in Utah. But then he used that money to go buy his family some gifts.
That's good.
Oh, nice. Look at you all wheeling and dealing, which is how you always do.
Oh, I was wheeling and dealing us some presents.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Do that tonight or after 2 weeks?
Let's do it tonight.
Yeah.
Wait, we got 2 weeks to enjoy them.
So, we have some presents for you. I think, right? Uh-huh. A few of them are in the box.
In the box,
we have another one, though. But I would be very interested to read that paper, because we've been wondering about the quarantine and how...
It's pretty strict.
I've seen other people's Facebook, and it doesn't seem so strict.
Driving around on Jeeps.
Yeah.
It's like, what the crap?